So generative AI in Photoshop is really powerful, but where it lacks is in resolution. Right now I'm going to show you two things. First of all, a brand new feature which helps us with that resolution, and then a tip that I have that will enable you to get full resolution no matter how large the image. So first of all, let's expand this image and see the problem. So let's grab the crop tool. With the crop tool selected, choose Generative Expand. And now when we click and drag to expand the image or outcrop it, I'm just hitting the Enter key. So now it's going to extend the image using Generative Fill AI. And if we look in the Properties panel, there's three variations. We can view each one of these. So they all look sort of good from a distance, but watch what happens when we zoom in. Double click the magnifying glass. This brings us to 100%. See how this image is nice and crisp and sharp? But uh-oh. When we get into the generated area, notice the resolution is just not there anymore. So in the Photoshop beta, there's a new feature that enables us to enhance the image. So if we roll over the variation, you'll see an icon. Click this icon. Now it's going to enhance the detail. And as you can see, it's not perfect, but it certainly is a lot better than what it was. So let's have a look and see what this enhanced image does. Then I'll show you a trick to get absolutely perfect resolution right now. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. In order to demonstrate how this works, let's use this picture of the cat. If we look, we can see this is 1280 by 1920 resolution. So right now we're in Adobe Bridge and we have a JPEG image. Let's open it in Camera Raw. Right click, choose Open in Camera Raw. Here we are in Camera Raw with the same image. Right click, choose Enhance, and then we're gonna look at Super Resolution. I've already done a tutorial on this before. I'll link it for you, and we can click Enhance. Now what happens if we look, a new image is being created, which is now 2560 by 3840. This is twice as large. So what Super Resolution does is it enhances the image and it upscales it. Kind of like what you would get with Topaz or Genuine Fractals or other upscaling software. So when we enhance these images, it literally feeds it through Super Resolution and brings it back. So it doesn't generate at a higher resolution. What it does is it takes that generated image and then it enhances it, upscales it, and makes it look a lot better. Now let's look at adding real resolution. So let's start with this image. We're going to grab the crop tool, just like we did before. We're going to use Generative Expand, and we're going to pull down, and let's hit Generate. And you can even see from a distance how terrible this looks. But even if we zoom in a little bit, let's have a look. Okay, that is not looking good at all. And if we hit the Enhance, it'll help a little bit, but it's not really going to. Look at that. It just creates a sharper version of this mess. So Generative Fill will generate a maximum of 1024 by 1024. This is the maximum size that it's able to generate at the moment. Hopefully in the future this changes. But if you wanted to fill a larger space, so what it does is it enlarges it to fill that space, which is obviously not the same resolution that you get on the original image. So the first thing you want to do is go to the icon in the layers panel, the padlock, and click on it. Convert it to a layer. Now we're going to go to our rectangle marquee tool. Under style, change this to fixed size, and then put in 1024 by 1024 pixels. Let's expand this image, and instead of generative expand, we're just going to choose transparent. Now, transparent will only be available when you've got this on a layer. Otherwise, it'll show a white background. But use transparent because it will generate better. If you have a white background, it will just generate white over the top of it. Okay, let's enlarge this now. And I'll just hit the Enter key. So what we've done now is we've enlarged our document, but we haven't generated the pixels yet. Okay, let's grab our rectangular marquee tool now. Remember, this is going to be limited at 1024 by 1024. So let's go into the first corner, and now we're going to hit Generative Fill, and we're going to choose Generate. And now it's generated. Let's double click and zoom in and have a look. And if we look at the image now, it's generating perfectly at full resolution. Let's look at the variations. Maybe we can go with that variation. And all you need to do now is just hit generate again, leave the text field blank, and then hit generate. And all you need to do now is just generate it in pieces like this, and then you're going to get a full resolution image that is good enough to even print. And if we look at this, it's done a much better job. Now, here's an extra tip. You can actually create an action to do this for you. In fact, I've created an action, and I'll put a link to it. You can see the image isn't necessarily perfect, but the resolution is. So thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new. Drop a comment underneath and let me know if you learned anything new or if you found this video useful at all. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. It's so great to have you here. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.